And welcome back, guys. We're going to be playing some more Wizards101. Make sure you hit that like button. Make sure you subscribe button. Let's get into it.
You warm the egg in the pure fires.
Thank you. Even now I can feel the baby drake stirring inside, warming to life. A drake's egg is hard and tough and cannot be easily broken. For this, we must aid the young drake. To this end, those in the hatchery use a sacred crystal hammer to crack the drake eggshell so the drakeling can break through. This hammer was taken by the gallium juggernaut. Go and find it, and take from it the crystal hammer we require. You have recovered for us the sacred crystal hammer. The hatching must take place on the center platform. Go, Wizardling, and face the one who keeps you from your sacred duty to hatch a new drake. When Snowcrusher is defeated, place the drake egg upon the central platform and use the crystal hammer on it.
You use the hand.
Thank you. I am pleased to meet you.
You have hatched a Drake egg, brought new life to this quiet, cold place. Congratulations, young wizard, and my eternal gratitude. Though I birthed the egg and you hatched it, the young drake must now learn our ways from all of the mother drakes. It is the tradition of our kind. Go and speak with the two other mother drakes in the hatchery. They will impart upon you valuable words of wisdom to teach your new drake.
Too long have the lessons I teach been unheard. I tell you then, a drake flies swift and true, and will take these words of wisdom to the new drake.
As is our tradition, honor.
And now I speak the final words of wisdom, those that apply to both Dragon Rider and young Drake. The bond you share is for life. Though you're from the Rider, the Drake takes compassion. You have done.
You again? What news do you bring? What? You hatched an egg? I'd never dare to dream. The young drake cannot fight. Not yet. Its scales have not hardened. It must have armor and learn the fighting ways of dragonkind. The spirit of the drake smith can help us, if it can be found. Go to the forum and see if he can be raised.
Who are you? Can you not leave me to my sorrows in this place of ruin? You're not from the Titan army, are you? What's that? You carry a Dragon Rider's staff? I can smell drakes on you. You've just helped a new drake hatch? If you want to become a Dragon Rider, you must understand our traditions and our methods. It is no small thing to control a drake. Go to the first room of the forum and read the great tome of Dragon Rider history.
You read the great tome of Dragon Rider history. It is a huge book, full of the stories of epic battles, the heroes of the Dragon Riders and their mighty drakes.
Excellent. You now bear with you the weight of our greatest prize. Don't think that your studies are done, young Dragon Rider. There are far more lessons to be learned before we would dare let you ride a drake. Go into the second room of the forum and read the second knowledge crystal.
Young wizard, it's time to learn a new spell. How exciting! Come to my classroom at once.
You read The Care and Feeding of Dragonkind, a comprehensive guide to all you would need to know to keep your drake healthy and well.
Excellent. No matter how much time you spend with your drake, it's essential to know how to care for it. The third knowledge crystal you must read is the most important. It will explain how to guide your drake into battle. You will learn how to stay in the saddle and how to avoid falling to your doom. The crystal is called The Fundamentals of Dragon Riding. This knowledge crystal is kept in the third room of the amphitheater. Go now and read it, and when you're finished, you will be ready to take wing.
The knowledge crystal is nowhere to be found.
The crystal is missing? Are you certain? That is unfortunate. Lessons contained within are essential for dragon riding. I suspect I know where the knowledge crystal has gone. We granted him access to our knowledge crystals, including the fundamentals of dragon riding, but he was instructed not to remove them from the forum grounds. Crasis may still be around. If you can find him, force him to surrender that knowledge crystal.
These crystals belongs to Crasis. Secrets of dragon riding are mine to use.
Again, you surprise me with your dedication. Thank you. Now that you've recovered the fundamentals with the knowledge crystal returned to its rightful place, it's time to read.
You read the fundamentals. It is a big book and covers a lot of ground, but there are helpful diagrams and lots of examples.
You've now learned all of the... We've spent enough time dwelling on the... We must forge armor for your new Drake. The first step is to relight the forge, cold all these years. To light it, for fuel you must defeat Fangtooth lava spinners and take from them their coal hearts. The flame must come from the flame sacks of burning flame wings.
Greetings, Maestro. Oh, this is no small thing. You must first go and speak to the Ice Tree Kelvin to learn about the Ice Titans before you can learn to summon one.
So, you want to learn more about the Ice Titans, one of the three great races of the Spiral. Before there was such a thing as time, the Titans, ice, fire, and storm, fought bitterly. Bartleby, the World Tree, and Grandmother Raven sought to calm the Spiral before it was destroyed. Through song, chant, and spell, they lulled the Titans into a slumber that has lasted all this time. Though most Titans still slumber, a few are awake and active in the Spiral. The Titans of Ice will aid those who show them respect. They dwell in a world of ice called Grizzleheim, linked to the Spiral by a mystic bridge. The Ice Titans, also called Frost Giants, take delight in defeating trolls. You must show that you are not afraid of trolls. Only then will a Frost Giant visit Wizard City and speak with you. In Krakatopia, you must defeat Crag Stonechin, defeat a burly troll of Marleybone, and Grum Foultooth from Mushu. When you have beaten them, return to speak with Professor Greyrose, and she will tell you how to summon the Frost Giant.
Thank you. Grom like war. Grom make war with you and win.
Thank you.
I suspect you've been up to some troll battling. While I don't condone violence for its own sake, it is a useful means of getting the frost giants to acknowledge your dedication to the School of Ice. The frost giants will surely listen to you now when you address them, but you'll still need to make them a suitable offering to summon the Rainbow Bridge. To bring it to Wizard City, you must create a tool to summon them. A horn of eternal wind. I will help you with the first part, gathering the raw materials. First, you need to get some pure loam from Lady Aurel in Unicorn Way's hedge maze. Though she's no friend to the frost giants, she should be willing to give you some. The next thing you'll need is a handful of Everfrost ice fragments from Colossus Boulevard. Kazul Ironhelm likely has some he can spare you. They're of no use to him. Return here when you fetch those things, and I'll tell you what to do next.
Greetings, young wizard. My, you've matured so much since I first met you in the early days of your arrival in Wizard City. You've come for pure loam? I can only imagine that it's for crafting a ceremonial instrument, like a horn of Very well, though I have my reservations about the summoning of frost giants to this part of the spiral, I will bow to your wishes and give you what you need.
Lady Aurel gives you a small bag of clay.
Thank you. Everfrost ice fragments. Sure, I've got some to spare.
Kazel pulls out a small leather.
Be careful with them. They'll freeze right to your skin if you handle them with your bare hands.
It looks like you've brought all the ingredients. Now we can begin.
Creating a horn of eternal winter is delicate and difficult work. The Everfrost ice fragments must be mixed with the pure loam in a magical heat more powerful than anything in Wizard City. You must go to Dragonspyre. You'll need a kiln. Use the flame kiln in Emil Flamewright's ring shop in the Athenium and Dragonspyre. Only the flame at Dragonspyre can melt Everfrost ice fragments into the pure loam. Here, let me show you how to make the...
Professor Greyrose instructs you in the technique of making the Horn of Eternal Winter out of pure loam and Everfrost ice fragments. When she's finished, you feel like you could do it in your sleep.
When you've finished making the Horn of Eternal Winter, return here to me, and I'll lay the final enchantment upon it.
As Professor Greyrose instructed, soon it shines in your hands. Despite coming from the heat, the horn is chill to the touch.
What you've made. Oh my, it's perfect. You're quite the crafter, you know. Give me a moment now.
Professor Greyrose mutters a few syllables under her breath, and the Horn of Eternal Winter begins to frost over. She hands it back to you.
There you go now. This horn will sound throughout the spiral and is sure to get the attention of the Titans of Ice. Now that you've made yourself a Horn of Eternal Winter, and I've placed an enchantment upon it to ready it for use, it is time for you to use the horn to summon a Titan of Ice and demonstrate your allegiance. You should go to a cold place. The most suitable one I can think of is along Colossus Boulevard. Try Hildreth's Perch near the Gobbler King's castle. That should be enough space for an Ice Titan. When you get there, blow your horn and wait.
You arrive at the courtyard and take out the Horn of Eternal Winter. It's ice cold to the touch. You take a deep breath and blow. The Horn of Eternal Winter echoes loudly throughout the area. From the echo, you are certain your call sounded throughout the spiral.
Who has dared summon the Ice Titan Ymir from his icy fastness in Grizzleheim? Who has blown the Horn of Eternal Winter? Show yourself. I didn't see you there. My apologies. Mortal wizard, despite your tiny size, you have slain trolls aplenty and proven yourself an ally to the Ice Titans. As a sign of our allegiance, you may summon one of us to aid you in combat. Go and speak to your teacher for the spell.
I see you return unscathed, so I can only assume things went well. With their permission, you may now summon a frost giant to aid you in battle. Do be careful out there.
You surely come from a long line of warriors. This is a great day indeed. Place the coal hots and the flame sacks within the forge, so that it will heat enough for us to make your drake's armor.
You place the coal hearts.
That's how to do it!
You ignite the forge. It burns brightly and gets very hot.
Alrighty, as I check the time, I notice we're at 1 hour and 21 minutes. Make sure to hit that like button, make sure to subscribe button. I'll see you guys in the next video.